Chapter 3 Wild Hunt is already an enormous sandbox, but modders have this talent of taking a good thing and making it even better. On that note, here are 5 pretty cool mods for The Witcher 3 that you should seriously consider installing should you be playing it on PC. For those of you hoping The Witcher 3 was going to look more like the trailer we saw at E3 2013, modders have come to the rescue. Seta Project have said the reason for the graphical deviation from its initial showing came down to having it look consistent over consoles and PC. But luckily for PC owners, the E3 FX mod by Drogon aims to bring it back to how we first saw it. The mod features improved texture sharpening and lighting, adjustments for bloom and saturated colors, and the removal of the game's yellow hue in favor of a colder look. If the darker look of E3 FX isn't your thing, you might also want to take a look at Cooly Sushi's Fantasy Graphics mod, which changes the look of the game to a more colorful, high fantasy palette. I find there's nothing worse than having heaps of awesome loot that you can't sell off because all the vendors are horribly poor, in RPGs and real life. Fine, sure, it makes sense for a humble village merchant to not have a ton of gold, but if you're a fan of sheer practicality who stops short of installing a gold sheet because you're a good person, you should check out the Wealthy Vendors with Fair Sale mod by Gekuman. Basically, this populates your game world with loaded vendors who want nothing more than to trade their sweet shiny gold for your mountains of crap. Speaking of mountains of crap, I have 2 more mods that might help you out on that front. Well, one is going to help you out and the other is probably going to make things much worse. Geralt may indeed be a handsome silver fox, but he can only carry so much. Unfortunately, that can mean cutting your super important adventuring in half to go back to town and empty your overburdened pockets. The over 9,000 weight limit mod, also made by Gekuman, relieves your burdens Lydia style by letting you turn up your carry weight limit to over 9,000.
It's over 9,000! What?
All the way up to 9,999 if you so choose, in fact. If you want to take full advantage of your new weight limit, you may also want to install the increased creature loot mod from Mindkiller 316. This mod ensures that monsters and creatures will always drop at least one piece of loot, and the drop chances for unique hides and natural ingredients are increased. But this one could be a killer if you don't have the previous mod installed. If you're one of those people who likes to mod all the way or not at all, then Witcher 3 Hunter's Config by Melek Toss is the one for you. Hunter's Config lets you get right down to it with a tool for configuring and tweaking a number of hidden settings in the game, which include audio, gameplay, rendering, and, well, basically every setting you can dream of wanting to configure. If you love tabs and sliders, download Hunter's Config. The Witcher 3's game world is pretty dangerous as it is, but if danger is your middle name and you want to kick it into overdrive, then you may want to check out Extreme Weather Conditions by KNG. Extreme weather should make you feel like even more of a badass, since now you can fight off beasties and save maidens in the pouring rain with low visibility. This mod makes winds stronger, clouds darker, and thunderstorms way, way more terrifying. If scary is what you're after though, the haunted Fike Island in the middle of a wild storm is probably your best bet. Seta Project Red have confirmed that they'll be releasing official modding tools for The Witcher 3 before too long, so all this is just the tip of the iceberg. Let me know down in that comment section what mods you'd like to see for The Witcher 3, and I'll catch you again next week.